rings in your face.
Naughty, naughty. A pretty girl?
All right, Thorpe. Have you seen Barnett? No. What?
Now, don't say this isn't your lucky day. Thousands of people travel hundreds of miles just for a brief glimpse of this wonderful yarmer. Now, here are the stables. Give the password. Open Sesame. And we gained on a fortune undreamt of by Ali Barber. And here he is himself. Cost only £168 and has won £56,420 sterling in stakes. Look at that shoulder. Look at the muscles, the suggestion of power in every line. Strength and elasticity, perfect chest development, and he certainly knows how to use those muscles. I'll say he does. You wanted action? Well, look at this. There he goes. Watch those strides. Three panels of the fence to each. The cameraman is racing up. Hold it. Who said the forefeet never leave the ground at once? And here's his father and a trainer himself, Harry Shelton.
Mr. Shelton, how many perch has Phar at run?
35.
35?
Yes.
And how did you come to call Phar at Phar? What does it mean?
Sky blue.
Here he is with 9 stone 12, 136 pounds, as a 4-year-old in the Melbourne Cup of 1930. £10,000 sterling that race was worth, and the best stayers in Australia were engaged. But Violet simply played with them. Here he comes now, over near the inside rails, going easily, but Pike's not going to take any risks. He's riding him out. The others are scrambling for second and third. No danger now. Here's the post, and Pike eases him. And now we'll see what Jimmy says about him himself.
Pike, what do you think of Phar?
As a horse? Well, I think Phar the greatest horse I've ever run. A phenomenal galloper. I think the best horse I've ever seen and ever run.
What were his prospects in America?
Oh, well. I think he's sure to do well in America, if he gets, if he goes through the trip all right. I think he's sure to do very well, and I think he's sure to win his race, because he's such a phenomenal horse, and I don't think that they've ever seen his equal.
Now you can all say goodbye to the conqueror. Like Christopher Columbus, he's going to discover America.